You, Katie, first of all, you have a big event coming up this weekend.
It's next week.
It's next weekend. Job fair. Mm-hmm. And what is this? Is this all different jobs
all
over the area?
Yep. So next Wednesday at Hartzell Inn from 10 to 3, we'll be having a job fair. It's our annual job fair. So just to give you a couple ideas, we'll be there. We'll have Adirondack Bank, Indium Corporation, MVCC, Excellus Blue Cross Blue Shield. So we got a wide variety of employers that'll be attending. But this Sunday, we'll have a full list and to give some job seekers kind of tips, you know, how to update their resume, what to wear, and all that type of stuff.
All right. That'll be they should look for it in this Sunday's OD.
Yes, this Sunday's OD.
And the event is next weekend.
Correct.
You were at our roast last night.
I was.
It was a good time last night.
I was very impressed with all of the roasters.
Everybody was funny.
Yes. Jeff was really good.
He was. Now,
He was a little too good.
Tell you that, I will tell you that I think he was very nervous.
He was. He came over to me, and I can see that he was very nervous.
I was very nervous, and I think... In order to quell to take the edge off the nerves, I believe that he might have had a few drinks.
Of water, right? A lot of water.
He hydrated.
Today he will.
Hydrated.
He may very well have overhydrated to the point where hold on, because can you just bear with me for a second? I think it's my mother who was actually at the roast last night. Mom, good morning.
Good morning.
Happy birthday, by the way. My mom celebrated her birthday last weekend.
Oh, happy birthday. Yeah.
So,
thank you.
Were you offended last night? They were going after me on some pretty personal issues last night.
I really thought it was going to be worse.
Oh, I love you, Mrs. Keeler.
Well, I did because Mark Butler caught us when we came in and he said, "This is going to be bad."
Oh, yes. Yeah, he was...
Oh, no. If it gets too bad, I was looking for the exit. I'll just leave. But, no, it was a lot of fun, and actually they said a lot of good things about you. I thought it was really nice.
Interestingly, the most uncomfortable parts of the night are when they say good things. I don't know how anybody else is, but when they're saying nice things about you, you're sitting there and everybody's looking at you. When they're saying bad things, it's easy. That's like, all right, bring it on.
It was nice. And I thought that, you know, everyone was, you know, they roasted you.
It wasn't
that bad.
Why is it? Do I feel that my parents enjoyed that? To be honest with you, I kind of.
In fact, we
did. I was hoping they wouldn't ask us to, you know, comment on something, and I thought, well, they said it all.
They said it all. Well,
they said it all. So it was really fun. We had a great time.
All right. Well, I'm glad to hear that. Thanks for piping in this morning. I appreciate it.
All right.
Okay. And there were a lot of people. There were a lot of people
there.
That was my biggest worry.
Really?
Is that you know, nobody, because it's tough. I know how I am when it gets to be Thursday night at 5 o'clock and I have tickets to go somewhere and I'm like,
but it's a roast for you.
Well, I had to go. I couldn't not go. Right. Oh, great. First my mom, now the mayor of Herkimer is on the line. Mayor Tony Brindisi. Good morning, Mayor. I hope you're still talking to me.
Who is this? Why are you calling me?
I didn't have anything on. I had nothing on John Scarano. And so I'm like, well, I'm just going to go after Herkimer. I don't know why that was.
You have nothing on John Scarano because he does nothing.
That's good.
What does he do? He goes around cutting ribbons. He says the same thing everywhere he goes. What does he do? He doesn't do anything.
As the roast continues.
Nice little guy, but, you know.
That's so funny. Listen, I just wanted you to know,
I love John. I don't want you.
I want you to know, I think the world of the village of Herkimer, it is where I really, you know, if you live in the valley, everyone, whether you live in Mohawk or Ilion or Frank, I mean, you grow up in Herkimer. It's where everybody did their shopping. I mean, think about it. In those days, we did school shopping in Herkimer.
No, comparatively speaking, compare it to the way it was when you grew up or when you were growing up, it's a lot different.
But, certainly is, yeah.
And if you ride through Herkimer real quick and you look around and you say, oh, my God. But the fact is, in the past 4 years, we've had 20 new businesses open up. and they're all family owned and operated.
Which is it does seem to be the niche that towns that go through difficult times. That seems to be the one common denominator. Is it's not the Kmarts of the world that are making the difference. That it's those family owned businesses, those private businesses, and small businesses that make these communities and reinvent communities like Herkimer.
That's sure, it's coming back. It's coming back slow, but we're doing it. We're doing it.
So, all right. Well, listen, I could not help myself. It was low hanging fruit, and I just had to go with it. And I apologize.
And what
greatly.
Else? I mean, what else can you grab? Is but low hanging fruit.
That's a good point. Thank you, Mayor. And by the way, at the Showtime 20th anniversary show, your son came home. And he was a part of the band Showtime, and he's currently in Ithaca. And that kid of yours is quite the talent and quite the showstopper. He definitely creates a scene when he comes out.
Bill, thank you for saying that. That's very gracious. He's a very good entertainer, and of course they all are very good.
Yeah,
entertainers.
No doubt.
Every
about
one of them, every one of those guys up there were incredible. But they did a great job, and we're very proud of my son, and we're very proud of all the guys. And it was a great show and a great turnout, and it's just a testament to the great talent in this area.
Yeah, no doubt about it.
Great talent, but those guys are fabulous.
All right, Mayor, thanks so much, and again, go Herkimer. All right,
thank you.
Okay,
thanks
so much, Mayor Tony Brindisi. The sheriff down there yesterday said, "Bill, I got to tell you, I mean, the roasting was like, and it will continue. It's like everybody was in the mix. And
oh yeah,
I would go up to a table, and the sheriff Farber is like, "Oh, Bill, I just want to tell you, we got the tickets, but I thought it was your father that was being roasted. We never would have come if I knew it was you." So yeah, but it was fun, right?
Can I say that Griffo's Photoshop skills?
Oh my God,
were on point. Yeah. My favorite was The Wizard of Oz.
The Wizard
of
Oz.
That was good.
You need to have that in the studio somewhere.
He provided us with pictures. They did a whole Photoshop montage of me in various scenes. And the last one, the movie that I was in, was me and Claudia Tenney.
Oh,
she played Arnold Schwarzenegger. I played Danny DeVito in Twins. And that cover is, we're bringing those in studio.
It was so
I'm gonna
good.
Frame them.
Yep.
They need to be here. But yeah, The Wizard of Oz. It's funny, my wife, we're going home, and she pulls them out, and she's looking at them, and she knows, oddly enough, I'm not sure which one of these three is you. yeah, and if you see the picture, you'd know. Those munchkins weren't good looking, let me just say.
Oh.
I guess it depends on the eye of the beholder. But
exactly, Bill, exactly.
All right, Katie, well, we had a good time last night, and most of us made it back in today.
Yes, that's
so
good, I see that.
We appreciate you coming out. And, of course, it goes to a great cause, the Historical Society. Mm-hmm. Those guys, and I was talking about earlier how everybody that bought their tickets and had them mailed, they came, each one came with a personal note, and that's just standard how they do it there.
Oh, I had them hold mine at the door.
You would have gotten a beautifully cursive written,
which some people don't know how to read.
I know, that's true.
I was dealing that with my son. He was never taught cursive.
They don't do that anymore.
Well, when I was in elementary school, they're in fourth grade, they're like, "This you will have to in high school, you'll have to write every essay, and it'll have to be in cursive."
Yeah.
How do people write their signature?
Different every time with a squirrel.
Well, yeah, mine's
squirrel
just
mine.
A scribble.
Yeah, that's what it is today, right?
Identity thieves.
I've actually been, when I go to vote, I've actually been yelled at by the volunteers there for the Board of Elections, yelled at because, I don't know, apparently my writing has changed over the years, and they pulled it out. See, this is what you were writing like when you were 18. Now look at this. What is this? You don't think you're a doctor, do you? Because you're not. Could I please vote? Yes, go over there. All right, so job fair is coming up. It'll be next week, but this weekend is important, again,
this weekend,
because...
on Sunday in the OD, we'll have a special section listing all of our employers that'll be at the job fair Wednesday the 25th at Hartzell Inn from 10 to 3. It's free admission, free parking, so come on out.
Nice. All right, Katie, and thanks so much again for coming out last night.
No problem.
So.